When we transmit power over a long distance, we face problem of voltage regulation, which means you're sending something else from one substation and on the other substation, you're getting something else. There is difference in the two voltage level. This is a very predominantly seen problem in the long transmission line, which are over 200 kilometer. And for sure, we need to compensate this effect. We need to balance the voltage regulation. And that's why sometimes we add shunt reactors in the system. But there can be a scenario where the load on the transmission line itself will take care of the voltage regulation. You will have the sending end voltage and the receiving end voltage as equal. And that load is what we refer to as a surge impedance load. In this video, we are going to understand what is the surge impedance load using a circuit simulation. Now, if you go to the courses.theelectricalguy.in, you will find a lot of courses that I have created on different topics of electrical engineering. If you find my YouTube videos helpful, then for sure you will love the different courses that I have created. All the courses available here comes with lifetime validity. It is fully self-paced. That means you can watch it anytime and anywhere and as many time as you want. It also comes with a 7-day money-back guarantee, and it is already helping a lot of students from different prestigious organizations. So definitely go and check out the courses that I have. It's on courses.theelectricalguy.in. I'll also put that link down in the description. Now let us get back to our transmission line. Now before we go and understand what is this surge impedance load, it is important that we understand what do we mean by the compensation of line. So let us understand that first. Now in the long transmission line, especially which are over 200 kilometers, we have voltage regulation problem. So you're sending one voltage from one end and you're getting something else at the receiving end. This is called as the Ferranti effect. We discussed about that in detail in one of the dedicated video. You can go and check it out for more details. But what happens is you're, let's say for example, sending 400 kilovolts from one substation, and at the receiving end you get 500 or 600 kilovolts. So it is sudden spike in the voltage. Let me show it to you in the action. So you see, I have a simple circuit simulation here. We have our source here at 50 hertz, and this is the equivalent circuit of the transmission line. This part here after the switch is basically our load, and we are considering this, it's a long distance transmission line. Now on this transmission line, the load is not full load, it is lightly loaded. So when the transmission line is lightly loaded, or there is no load at all, the voltage at the receiving end goes to a very high level. Let me actually show it to you. I'm gonna run the simulation here. So you see the green value indicates here is the value that we are sending, which is 353 kilovolts RMS. But at the receiving end, which is shown by this purple waveform, you can see it's 456 kilovolts, right? So you're sending something else and you're receiving something else on the receiving substation. This is certainly not acceptable because your equipments are meant for, let's say, 350 kilovolts, but you are getting 450 kilovolts. So this is a problem, and this happens, and this is a real problem. This is not something theoretical or, imaginary. This happens real in the transmission system. And at this particular scenario, the voltage regulation is very bad. And this is what we call as the uncompensated line. Why this is happening? Because there is no sufficient inductive reactance in the system, but the capacitive reactance is present and that is dominating, and at the receiving end you're getting high voltage. We discussed that in the Ferranti effect video. So this is certainly a problem, and this is called as uncompensated line. So how do we address that? How do we compensate the line? Of course, by adding sufficient inductive reactance in the system. So let me go and add a reactor in the system, and then we see what happens. So now here we have added a reactor in the system. You see, this is the reactor that we have added, and for time being we have added a switch so that we can switch it when we want. Now I'm going to run the simulation again, and now we will see what is the voltages that we have here. So here is the volt simulation is running. Currently I have not attached the inductor or the reactor in the system, and you see there is a voltage difference in the sending and receiving end. So now I'm going to add a reactor in the system. So I'm going to close this switch. So the switch is closed and you can see the voltage is now getting back to the normal. That means the sending and receiving end voltage are now identical, almost identical. This difference, 5% difference, 5% variation is acceptable, right? So this is what we did. We added a reactor and we compensated the line. This is what we call as the line compensation, right? But you need to understand what was the root cause of this voltage spike. The root cause was because there was no sufficient inductive reactance. The capacitive effect was dominating. And as a result, we were getting higher voltages at the receiving substation. So if this is true, that by adding the inductive reactance in the system, if we are able to compensate the line, then it should be also true that if the load on the line increases, then the voltage balance will happen. Well, it happens. Let me actually show it to you using the simulation again. So I'm going to remove the reactor from the system, and you can see the moment I remove the reactor, the voltage at the receiving end goes up, right? Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust the load and then you see what happens. So you see I've slightly increased the load and the voltage change is there. So voltage was initially more than 450 kilovolts, it is now reached to 420 kilovolts. So from that, if I again go and further increase the load, then maybe we will reach to a load where the sending end voltage and the receiving end voltage becomes equal. I don't know, let's have a look. So I'm again going to increase the load here. So I'm just varying only one parameter, the other parameter I'm just keeping the same for simplicity. And you see now almost the sending end voltage and the receiving end voltage are identical, same, right? We have not added any reactor, we have not added any capacitor banks or any other mean of compensation, right? The load itself is compensating the line. The load itself is taking care of the voltage regulation of the line. And this particular load is what we call as the surge impedance load, where we don't need any sort of additional compensation media to achieve the voltage regulation. The load itself is taking care of the voltage regulation. And this type of transmission line is called as self-compensated line. Right? Clear? But of course, this is not possible practically, right? So the load cannot be constant. Load is dynamic. It always keeps changing. So when the load on the transmission line increases, right, then the surge impedance load, then your voltage will decrease. Let me actually show you. So I'm again going to further increase the load here, and you should see. See, I've increased the load and the sending end voltage has dropped to 220 kilovolts. So when that happens, you will have to add capacitive reactance in the system. Why? Because now the inductive reactance is dominating the system and there is no equal and opposite capacitive reactance to oppose that. So you will have to add capacitor banks in the system to do that. The opposite is also true. When the load on the transmission line decreases, again the capacitive effect will dominate and then you will have to add the inductive reactance in the system to compensate the line if the load is not at the surge impedance load. And in practice, that is what happens. So in practice, the voltage or the load on the transmission line keeps changing. Sometimes it is more than the surge impedance load, sometimes it is less than the surge impedance load. And in order to balance the voltage, in order to have a better voltage regulation, you will have to switch on the reactance, switch on the capacitance based on the loading of the transmission line. And that is done by the static VAR compensator or SVC. Now they will be able to do the switchings based on the load on the transmission line. Now, if you want me to make an introductory video on what is static VAR compensator, then comment SVC in the comment section below. If I get enough comments, then for sure, I'll be making one dedicated video on that. But I hope you understood the concept of what is surge impedance load. In a summary, in a nutshell, it is the load at which the transmission line will compensate itself. The load itself will take care of the voltage regulation. That is nothing but the surge impedance load. If you want to learn more about what is Faraday effect, how reactor helps us in adjusting the voltage, I have dedicated videos on that. I put link for both of those videos down in the description. You can definitely go and check it out to learn more about that. So I hope you are clear with this thing, and if you found the video helpful, then do like the video and do share it with the people you think might be interested in learning about these things. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in my next one. But till then, keep watching, keep learning.